All right, guys. My name is Coach Justin Clark. I'm the head football coach at North Gaston High School here in Dallas, North Carolina. I'm here to talk about the Carolina Shoot, which is kind of an offset of my version of what I believe is the greatest offense that was created, which is the run and shoot. And so what you see here is how you can get in touch with me. Feel free any time to shoot me a message via Twitter, my cell phone number, shoot me a text. You know, I love to talk ball. Anything that I can help you with or anything I can learn from you, please, please let me know. And so, you know, that's kind of what we're going to be doing today. I talked with Coach and kind of some things that we're going to talk about today is, you know, what is the run and shoot? We'll kind of go over some of our group pass drills, and I'll show you some film with that. We'll tell you how we use the R4 language and cap space sheets with our cover sheets to break down routes. And then we'll talk about how we create our routes and develop our routes. And so with that in mind, you know, hopefully you guys get something out of this. You know, and feel free to shoot me a text or shoot me a message on Twitter anytime you can. Okay. And so, first thing that we want to talk about, you know, is what is the run and shoot? And I got a lot of this information and I like this information from a coach in Virginia named Mark Poston. I'm sorry, coach, if I said it wrong. But I think the way that he explains the run and shoot, was very influential as I started creating and coming up with my own philosophy. And so, you know, what the run and shoot is, what it isn't, and why is it different? What the run and shoot is, it gives the receivers the ability to adjust their routes post-snap according to the coverage and leverage of the defender. And so, in my opinion, this is radically different than all other passing attacks because this is what makes the run and shoot so valuable to our system because we ultimately have the chalk last. And so no matter what covers that you're in, no matter what you try to do to us, we're always going to have an answer if our receivers are on the same page or what they see. Okay. All route packages will work against all coverages. Okay. And that's what we're saying. If the receivers understand leverage, they understand where they need to be in space and make the correct reads, all of the route packages that we have work against all coverages. And so we're not sitting here game planning each week and saying, okay, they're a cover four team. We need to work our cover four packages. They're a palms team. We need to work some of our palms packages. Everything that we do in our system should work in every coverage. Okay. So ultimately, that takes a lot of the pressure off of the play caller because you don't have to be perfect on every single play call because that's not the design that we're trying to get. Okay. The design of this offense is to have the chalk last. We have the answer and then we can go. We don't have to have any kind of blitz packages as far as, you know, what we do because our blitz breaks are built into every route package. So we don't necessarily need to audible that much in this system. Okay. So teaching the run and shoot, it's more simplistic than people think. It's based off of some simple principles that all skilled players must know. We read top down. Okay. And I think this is the same for pretty much all of our passing game, but we really want to attack the safeties. We want to vertically attack space, not just horizontal stretches, but we want to vertically stretch the defense. So we read the top down of a defense, safety to corners to linebackers. Understand you're not only looking for pre-snap alignment, but leverage of the defender as well. So how many safeties are there? Once we identify the safeties, then we look at corner leverage. And then once we see the corner leverage, now we're trying to find what they're doing in the box. Okay. And so for example, with our seam read, understand what the run and shoot poem is that everybody likes to talk about. If he drops, I stop. If he cross, I cross. If he's even, I'm leaving. We make no breaks before 10 yards except for blitzes. And so we have to run through the under coverage before we can make our break in our post-snap read. Okay. So don't confuse under coverage with safety coverage. All right. So, and that's the thing. Once we start to understand with our receivers is we have to understand and don't get confused between safety coverage and under coverage. If your man blitzes, apply the hot principle. Okay. So it's real simple, you know, and so the application and practicing the shoot, this is kind of what we end up teaching day one, how many safeties we're going to read hash to hash. We tell our quarterbacks, let's just go ahead and read left to right. Okay. So we go left hash to right hash. At the beginning of the system, we have the quarterback point to the safeties to let the receivers know if it's middle of the field open or if it's middle of the field closed. So we have the quarterback tell our receivers early on if the middle of the field is open or middle of the field is closed. Okay. And when we talk about coverages, there's really only five coverages that we really hit for our receivers and quarterbacks. We don't really teach them or want them to know the difference between what cover six and cover seven is in our language. but we teach them 1-3. We teach them cover zero, cover two, cover four, and cover five, which is what we call two man package. Okay. And so when we sit here and we practice the run and shoot, these are kind of our group pass drills. We run a seam read drill, choice drill, streak, rails. And so all of this is really in our indie time. Okay. And so our group is when we really run our indie period. And so we hit a specific drill, 1 to 2 drills during that indie time every single day. Okay. And so that's kind of how we practice the shoot. And so with these group drills in the pass game. All right. And before we talk about that, we'll kind of come back to this. But there are seam read drill, all right? All receivers work versus the middle of the field safety, and then they work all reactions, okay? How he drops, how he cross versus rotation versus man. And so we work all of these things before we go, okay? So what our seam read drill is kind of looks like this right here, okay? We'll have a coach on top on both hashes, all right? We'll have our outside receivers running the switch seam. We have our slots running the inside seam, okay, and then they just flip-flop each line as they get reps, okay? And so with this thing and how we can go back to this and how we teach our coverage is we go back to what Coach Maddox and with the R4 language is we look at these zone spokes, okay, and we teach our coverage through what we talk about with zone spokes, okay? And so, for example, if we see a team that's playing cover three, okay, how are they playing cover three? Is that corner dropping straight? Is he a vertical dropper? Or does he try to overlap and get in between the two verticals? And so if he overlaps and he tries to play in between, we call that a three spoke. If he's dropping just vertical and trying to maintain leverage over top of number one, then we call that a cover four spoke. And so now we can sit here and we can attack each individual player and know where that player is attacking. Okay. Is he a two spoke? Does that safety get off the hash with the two spoke? Is he a four spoke? Does he stay on the hash? Does he rotate to the middle of the field? Is he playing a one spoke? And so now we can get on the same language with our receivers and quarterbacks. Okay. So this is what you see. When we talk about the coach would just look at each other and say, hey, we're going to be a four spoke. And so now with this receiver, okay, if that coach drops vertical, okay, so let's go back to the poem. If that coach drops, I stop. And so now I can run my hunt route, okay? And so now we're looking at the switch over here on the right-hand side, okay? If that coach now goes to a two spoke, and he comes off the hash and he crosses me, then now I cross him and I run the post, right? If that coach now drops to a one spoke and he goes to the middle of the field, now we know that we have uncapped space on the hash and now we're going to run our seam through the hash, okay? And so we just work that. This is almost an everyday drill with us, okay? This is a seam read drill, all right? Next thing that we end up doing is a choice drill. All receivers work against cover three corner to learn the steps of the choice. Then now we go corner to hash safety to learn the cover two breaks. And then we'll work against cover zero and then press corner, cover two corner And then we'll kind of work with the outside linebacker and work on blitz breaks if we get to that point as well. Okay. And so with our choice drill, all right, we have both lines on the outside. We have the quarterback in the middle of the field. Okay. We're working now. If that corner is sitting here and now I drop at a four spoke, okay, now we're just reading leverage on that seventh step. Okay. If he's over and inside of me, okay, if he's over the top of me and inside leverage of me, I can't run the post. So now we run the speed bench. Okay. If I three spoke it, if I go three spoke and he tries to overlap, okay, then I definitely know that I can't run the post. I'm going to run the snap. I'm going to run the speed bench. Okay. If that corner tries to play me flat on the flat spoke or play a read spoke, then now I know I'm going to be even and then I'm leaving on that seventh step. Okay. And so we just work these steps throughout. Once we get good at a cover three and a loose leverage technique, then we'll put a safety. We'll put a safety in the field with choice, and then now we can work. Okay, if that's flat, okay, now we can work the safety. Okay, if that corner's here, he four spokes. That corner four spokes. Now we don't want to get leverage on that post. We don't want to run into it. We can kind of flatten that off into the hole. There's a lot of different things that we can do with that as well. Okay. And so our 90 street drill, same thing with the seam drill, seam read. So now we're just running our 90 streak on the backside. Okay. Quarterbacks are now dropping. So now we're running 91 with this here, because 91 will have the play concept called this side. We're working now 91 package on the backside. Okay. So with that, with the 91 and 90s with the streak, okay, we can now work the coverage spokes with this to understand what we do in space. Okay. Same thing with our rails with 70. Okay. It's the same drill with our streak. Now we're just working two different people with it. Okay. Once we get done with our 2x2 game, we can get into our 3x1 package. And what I like doing with this 3x1 drill is work your 3x1 concepts to this with this quarterback, working the field concepts, the backside quarterback number two, now he's working choice. So you can kind of get a 2-for-1 deal with these 3x1s. Okay. So for here, we're working smash. We can work go. We can work divide. We can work Georgia. We can work a lot of different things. On the backside, we're working choice. Okay. Then we have routes on air. All right. Then we have the choice drill, which is full. So then with the routes on air, we can go with that as well. Okay. All right. So now when we look at this, let's kind of go back to what it kind of looks like with film. And I apologize. This is kind of the first few days that we put this in. I just took this job in January. And so this can kind of give you an idea of what we do. Okay. So with this in mind, we see we're running rails. Quarterbacks, their eyes, they're dropping this way, but their eyes should be going to their progression first. Their eyes went way too quick to this backside. Okay. All right. So now with this in mind, all right, once we're running the switch, okay, once we're running this switch, now that outside receiver is running his route on the hash safety. Okay. This receiver is now running his rail read off of that corner, and he's going to read corner leverage. All right. So now let's kind of look at this inside streak read. Corner comes down. All right. That corner comes down. He plays a read technique. Okay. That's what we call a read technique. All right. He crosses him. Okay. All right. So once he crosses the undercoverage and run through the undercoverage, I can make my route. Okay, I can make my route adjustment. Now, this is wrong. Okay, quarterback sees it. He puts him on the hash, okay, which is where he needs to be. All right, he got confused because he saw the corner play a cover three spoke, okay, and he got confused and wants to run away from coverage, okay? That's not his read anymore, okay, because if that happens, okay, if that happens and that corner overlaps, now we have the check down because now the corner overlap. He played a three spoke. I can't beat him deep. So then that on the rails, he just sits down with it. Okay. All right. All right, now let's look at it again. We got Rails. So we see that the hash safety, he force posts, he drops vertical. We see a bender going in, makes a right read. On the outside, we're looking at cover, we're working, he drops, I can't beat him deep, I sit it down. Okay, we gotta make a throw. All right, this looks good right here. We got Rails. We see that safety now dropping vertically. So if he drops, I stop. Now, once that receiver sees him drop, okay, now he's going to get his eyes into this under coverage and get his eyes on this linebacker. If that linebacker now drop and he expands vertically, now I'm just going to hunt the hole, okay, and we're gonna run our hunt route across the middle of the field. Okay, same thing. Corner now bails. I can't beat the safety. I can't beat the corner. So now once that corner drops, I stop, and then I have the check down. Quarterback is just a cross field read on his progression. I should be 1 to 2 to 3 to 4 with that progression going in. Okay, so you can see the quarterback's eyes with this. This is wrong. Their eyes should be going play side first and then coming backside to get the time to get the timing. Okay. Now, as we look at it and how we began to start teaching our guys what routes to run versus what coverage, we look at our coverage sheets with it. And then I got this from Coach Maddox and just talking with him, about how we can implement the run and shoot in the R4 language. Okay. And so we print off sheets with our receivers, with our quarterbacks. We give them these cover sheets. We have now our tubes that we need to attack with our cushion, our collision, our crossover tubes. And then now we just sit here and we break down each route based off of what the coverage is. Okay. And so we see cover 3, we see cover 1. What are we going to do versus a man break versus a zone turn or man turn versus cover 2? How are they playing it? Where are we going to attack it? Same thing with 2-man with cover 5. Again, same thing with cover 4. How are we going to attack cover 4? Okay. Same thing with cover 0. All right. So now when we look at it, we can get into the same 3-by-1. Okay. The only difference is now the crossover tube stays on the box. We move the collision tubes over. So it's cushion, collision, collision, crossover, cushion. Okay. And then now in trips, how are we going to attack cover 3? Versus every single route that we do, okay? How are we gonna now run a go versus cover 1? How are we gonna run go versus cover 2? How are we gonna run Georgia, okay? And what's the progression on Georgia versus a cover 2 look? Things of that nature, okay? So once we get done, we'll have these printed off. We give these to our receivers, then we move into our breakdown, and we can go in. From there, and it kind of looks like this right here. And so we'll break down. Let's look at Hoss. So this is what we run. Kind of our day one install is our quick Hoss, and we'll tag a lock on the backside. Okay, so we have a hitch conversion. We're going to talk about route development. Before we get to this, let's talk about route development. And then we'll get into these cover sheets, okay? So how we set up our pass game and create our route packages is what I think separates run and shoot, okay? And with this route development, we do these in 3 different ways. We do it through conversion routes. We do it through the same beginning with different endings, okay? And then we do same structure but different formations. All right. And so there's a lot of different ways that we can run our route packages based off of what you're going to do to us defensively. Okay. So we can be creative or we can be as base as we want to be. Okay. And so when you look at it and you talk about conversion routes, okay, we're going to read coverages on the run. This is what a lot of people see with the run and shoot and believe that the run and shoot is. Okay. It's just conversion routes everywhere. That's a main part of our system, but it's not the only part, okay? So we're going to read coverages on the run, each receiver reads a part of the coverage. For example, this is Hoss. Okay, so you'll see it 2x2, how we're running Hoss. You'll see in 3x1, how we're running Hoss. Okay, so this is a conversion route. This is you know, our number one way of creating routes and route packages. The second thing is same beginnings with different endings. Okay, three routes have similar stems at the departure point, and they all go in different directions. Okay, so we can see this in a high-low concept. We can see this in a sail concept, and then we can see this ultimately in a vertical concept. Okay, so now let's say we want to put an inside linebacker on a high-low predicament. All right, so what we can end up doing is now running our levels package. All right, for this we're running 81 swap levels, and we're tagging L on the bench. Okay, all right. So now we're going to high-low. Okay, inside linebacker, apex defender. Okay, so we're going to run levels. All right, so another way that we can do this with the same beginning, okay, is now we can go swap sail. Okay, so now we can sit here and we can run 60 swap sail. All right, and it's the same beginning, but we have a different ending. All right, the last thing that we can do is a vertical concept. We can run divide, okay, and now we can go swap divide, and now we can attack the safeties on this, and we can get the ball vertically downfield. And so it's the same beginning, but we have different endings with this. And so we can window dress a lot of things that we can do in our route packages as well. The last thing that we talk about when developing routes is the same structure concept, but different formations, okay? And this is kind of more of the West Coast influence with Coach Jones, with you know, flat curl. These Georgia and Nebraska concepts is kind of what has overtaken the old school slide concept. And so you see a lot of West Coast influence with these levels package and then this curl flat package. Okay. And so what we end up doing is running 3x1 to the trips, running curl flat to the trips. All right. So again, same structure, same play. All right, same thing with the 3x1 to the single receiver. Now we can run our curl flat to the single receiver, and kind of just flip the concept, flip that concept, and then we can go same thing with our 2x2. All right, still run curl flat. Now that's a Nebraska call to us. We can still high low with this and still get a curl flat package on the same thing with a one high beater and a two high beater. And so there's different ways that we can attack, and we can create routes and design routes. Okay. First thing is route conversions. Next thing is same beginnings with a different ending. Okay. So now we can window dress some things, and then now we can run the same concept and have a more of a West Coast influence. So same concept with different formations. Okay. And so that's how we kind of break down what we're doing with it. And so it's been really good to us. Okay. And so now when we look at Hoss and how we break down the understanding of what we're doing in the pass game with it, is now what we're sitting here and we're teaching this on the hitch read. Let me get to what we talk about with this. So now on 50 quick Hoss, all right, and we're looking with this hitch read. What we're telling our outside receivers with the hitch read is now he's going to push vertical for 8 yards. Okay. If now that defender, he's reading corner leverage. Okay. He's reading corner coverage. If corner drops, okay, if he drops, I stop. Okay. All right. Always kind of go back to that poem. If you get confused with anything in the run and shoot, all right, if he's giving you a 3-spoke or he's giving you a 4-spoke, okay, I'm going to run a hitch. He's playing me soft coverage. All right, if that corner is now playing a read technique, or he's playing a cloud technique, a flat technique, all right, and now we see middle of the field open, we know that's primarily a cover two jam. All right, so now we're going to convert that into a vertical route on the outside with the MOR, okay? And then if he's playing us any type of man coverage, okay, now we're going to end up running a fade stop on the outside, okay? So now with our inside, with our live seam, with our seam read here, okay, all right, on Hoss, we tell that inside seam, okay, we're going to outside release. We have the outside release gaining the outside hip of that apex defender, okay? Don't make our route adjustment until you run through the undercoverage, okay? Once you run through the undercoverage, and then my eyes now go to the safety, okay? If that safety is on the hash and he force spokes, okay, if he force spokes, now I'm just going to now stop. He drops, I stop, work to run my my hunt route. If that safety is now playing a two spoke and he crosses the hash and he crosses my face, I cross him and I run the post. And then now if that safety one spokes or he comes down and plays a read or a flat technique, okay, and now we have uncapped space, I'm going to go get into uncapped space. Okay. And so that's kind of what the picture looks like. And then now we can sit here and we can break this down. Okay. So now we can look, we're going to run, our base formation. All right. And now let's work hoss with this. So if we're working on a worksheet with this right here, now we have this on the screen, we're running now 50 quick hoss L lock. Okay. So now we have what we can end up doing is sitting here. Okay. We're going to sit now corner three spokes, he drops. So now I know I'm going to run my hitch. Okay. So I'm looking to outside release leverage, get through the under coverage. Okay. Get through the under coverage. There's nobody in my tube. I am uncapped. Okay. I'm uncapped. So now I'm going to get into uncapped space. Okay. Same thing. Get outside leverage, run through the under coverage. I have a locked seam. I don't have any kind of seam read on this. I have a locked seam. Same thing on the backside. Okay, that corner three spokes, he's soft leverage. And so now versus cover three, this is what Hoss looks like. Okay, all right, so now, all right, now let's look at cover one. Okay, and now let's look at cover one with this. Okay, so now we're sitting here, all right, now we're sitting here with Hoss. I'm playing a man technique, okay? I'm going to now get here. I am looking, okay? I'm looking for the fade stop around now 15 to 17 yards to be thrown back shoulder, all right? It's a man technique. We're looking in the man turn to the corner. Now I'm working back shoulder to get the ball thrown. Same thing, outside leverage with the release. I'm working a man technique. If I can't beat him vertically on this tube, okay, if I can't beat him vertically on the tube, I know once I get the 15 yards, I'm on a man break, okay? I'm on a man break, and now I'm going to cross his face, okay? And same thing, we have a lock seam on the backside. It doesn't matter what covers that is, okay? It's still the same thing on the backside of this. We're looking at fade stop, okay, on the backside because it's a man technique, okay? So now, same thing with the quarterback. We're looking here. Okay, we're going 50 with our protection. And so we go 1, 2, 3 to 4. Very simple read, cross field read. Okay, now let's look at cover two. Okay, we're working Hoss on cover two. Okay, so now we sit here and we're working Hoss, okay, with the coverage sheet and how easy it is now to teach, in my opinion, how easy it is to teach run and shoot based off kind of what Coach Maddox is doing with this R4 language. And it really, with these tubes, it has exponentially allowed our guys to understand the run and shoot at a much faster rate, okay? And so with these cover sheets and with these tubes, now we can teach this at a quicker pace, okay? So now on Hoss, let's go back and look at it. Okay, we get a flat coverage with that corner leverage. Okay, I'm now going to get here. I'm outside release. Okay, and then now I know I got to get into open space. Okay, same thing with my inside seam read. I got to get outside leverage, go through the under coverage. Okay, and now with that safety running a two spoke, okay, that safety crosses me. Right, so I cross him, and now we're running the post in between it. Same thing on the backside. We lock it, okay? We lock it. So that's here, and then same thing on the backside with that hitch read, Okay. Same thing on the backside with the hitch read. We got to get into vertical space. Okay. And so again, day one install for us on Hoss. And you can see kind of what the run and shoot mentality is. When you think of air raid, and it's no knock to the air raid, I think it's a great system. When you look at it, I think it has to do a lot with horizontal stretches. Okay. When you look at stick, when you look at corner, when you look at mesh, there's a lot of horizontal stretches in the air raid system. With us, we want to get in a run and shoot, in a Carolina shoot, or any kind of post-snap coverage reads, we want to vertically attack space, okay? And we're going to teach our guys to vertically attack open space and run competitively to space, okay? And so that's been good with us and kind of how we break this down with it. Let's look at one of our hosses is a day one install. Let's look at film with our number two day one install. And this is one of my favorite concepts that we run. Okay. And so with look, now all we're doing is running slot option. Okay. All right. So now we're just running slot option. We're looking, we're our 50 bow. Okay. Let me get back to it. 50 bow is just regular fade out. All right, so now what you sit here and see, okay, we're in 2x2, okay, and what we end up telling our receivers with this route package, it is a inside slot option read. Our 50 is a mirrored series, okay, and so we can talk about that later on. But with look, we have a mandatory, we have MORs on the outside, okay, which is mandatory outside release, okay. So these guys have mandatory outside release. They've got to get to 6 yards or gain their leverage, okay? And then now they can run hitch, they can run slant, or now they can run flat. Same thing down here on the bottom. They can run hitch, they can run slant, they can run out, okay? And it's based off of leverage, all right? And so now we can run this package two different ways. We have, or three ways. We got 50, which is a mirrored. We can go our 90s package, which is now we can tag it, which is streak with inside slot option, or we can go 70s, which is rails with this inside slot option. And so we have a lot of different varieties to run this. Okay. And so now when we look at this, you can see quarterback, we're telling him 50. Okay. We're in a 4-1 box. All right. I've got head up leverage. Okay, this safety is inside leverage. I mean, this apex player is inside leverage, which is eyes on the inside. So receiver knows he's probably going to be 90% that he's about to blitz. Okay, so now let's look at what this slot receiver does with his option. Okay, so now as I get in, he kind of wants to cross his face, but he still stays vertically with it. Okay, receiver sees this. He's good either way. Okay, he's good either way. All right, he ends up breaking an inside break, okay? All right, now we just got a pitch and catch, all right? Okay, so he's good either way. That slot is correct either way. I'm good, okay? All right, now let's look at down here to the bottom, okay? Down here to the bottom, he sees blitz. Now I just sit down, all right? And quarterback would have seen this on the backside. All we have to do is just grip and rip right here for an easy gain. Okay. On the outside, we see outside MORs. They do what they're supposed to do. Okay. They hold the corner. Okay. What we do not want is now to run a fade out type concept versus a cover two. Okay. And that inside, the outside receiver inside release. And now that corner is going to go head hunt that inside slot. Okay, we tell them, okay, don't force your guys into the hospital with that. All right, now, okay, we go back to a two high structure. We have 50 look. Okay, pre snap leverage. He's kind of inside already. He's inside already. Let's look here at the concept side with 50. Okay, we get a jam corner on both. So now we see that it's cover two. We get bad release. That should not happen here. We got to get an outside release. Quarterback pisses me off, throws it to the outside. We still get a completion. I have no idea how it works, but broken play and it still works. Okay, still same thing. Let's look at the option route. Okay. All right, so again, once we get gain leverage, we're telling our receivers to get the six, but we can run this once we gain the leverage of that defender. We're running hitch, slant, or out, okay? I would have liked to seen him run an outside. I would have personally liked to seen him run a flat, but now with the head-up defender, he's good either way. Okay, he's good either way. All right. Let's look down here to the bottom. He gains leverage. Okay, he gains his leverage. Okay, he's inside of me with his hips turned. Okay, I know this matchup, I can cross his face. I'm 100% okay with him doing that. Okay, I'm 100% okay with him doing that because I know that this player now against this player is the matchup that we want to throw it to. Okay. This is one of the, this guy ended up going to Kent State. I like that matchup on that outside linebacker. All right. So now we go Rio move in the 51 look. I think this is where he tries to break it back inside when he's supposed to break it out. He got fancy there. There's no reason. Number one, he cut the route short. Okay. He runs a 2 yard route. That shouldn't be there. Quarterback now sees bump. For some reason, he goes backside. All right, bad releases on the outside. We got to get outside release. Top slot, okay? He sees drop, okay? He sees now hitch. And this is where we got to be good at coaching it. If you're going to now run a hitch, run a hitch. If you're going to run a slant, run a slant. Okay. Be clear to what the quarterback is now going to throw it to. Okay. Because he sees a receiver wanting to go break inside. All right. So he throws a slant when now he just kind of button hooks it in there and runs a hitch. That doesn't need to happen. If you're going to run a hitch, all right, plant your feet, come back downhill. All right, so now we got 51 look. All right, again, on the outside, okay, we got the outside release. Okay, we got to outside release this. So 51 look, outside release, okay, run my option. Okay, run my option with the slant, hitch, and out. Same thing on the bottom, okay? Same thing on the bottom here. I got slant, I got hitch, I got out. Okay, MOR to this side. Okay, both of these guys were wrong, okay? And they didn't grade out very, very well this game. All right, down here to the bottom. Inside releases, forces the corner to come back inside. Okay, he runs what he's supposed to run. Okay, runs the out. Ball come here is either going to get picked or his head's going to get knocked off. Okay, his head's going to get knocked off. Now we get to the field. Okay, we go to the field with this. I would like him to press the defender's feet a little bit more. He runs a route short. But the ball should be thrown right now in that first window on that slant. Boom, throw it right now. Okay, throw it right now. It's first and forever. Let's get this 10 to 15 yards on a quick slant. Get us back into reasonable down and distance. Okay, he sees a safety. Okay, I see what the quarterback sees. Okay, there's a free hash safety. Okay, who stays on the hash. He thinks he can hole shot it into the window. All right. He could hole shot it if it was an outside release. All right, the ball should be thrown over the top, but woulda, shoulda, coulda is we get you beat every time. All right, 51 look. Okay, we see a cover one to one coverage, man free coverage. We're sitting here outside leverage. We're going to MOR. Okay, we see an outside release by this route. Okay, which is the correct read. That's good. Down here to the bottom. He opens his hips too fast. Receiver thinks that now, and he knows that he can beat him based off of leverage. He breaks the slant, gets into the second window for good, good first down throw. Okay. We got 51 look. We're running here on the inside. Okay. We see now, let's take a chance. Okay. Based off of down a distance. Okay. We know, all right, this is a man look. All right. Let's take a chance on the outside. If you have the matchup, let's throw the ball vertically down the field. Okay. We have to do a better job of restacking and getting back to our leverage. Okay. First thing is, he's in here too tight. He needs to be on the top of the numbers. He's a yard inside, okay? We need to be on the top of the numbers on this route, okay? We have to expand release and get back on the yellow line. All right, let's get back to our landmark, okay? Let's get back to our landmark. Quarterback sees one-on-one coverage, okay? This receiver ended up going to App State. He likes the matchup. We got to get back on our landmark. All right, so 51 look. We see a middle of the field open structure. All right, we're more head up. He's inside leverage with it. He's inside leverage with it. So pre-snap, okay, pre-snap, I'm thinking out and out if I'm a quarterback. Okay, so pre-snap, I'm thinking I got fade outs to both sides. Okay, now let's look at leverage. It's 51, so let's look here to the bottom. Let's work here to the bottom. Okay, 1, 2, 3. Like to get a little bit deeper on that route. He felt that he widened. He widens. I break the slant. Okay. Get middle of the field open. Find second window slant. Split the safeties. And now let's go score. All right, same thing with 50 look. We see kind of, you know, second and six. This is a great call. I think it's a really, really good call. High percentage throw. This Hoss and look is one of my go-to routes in 2x2 versus any coverage. Okay, so when you look at it with this, all right, we see another kind of a two-man, concept. We don't see the safeties. You see kind of the shadow and the shadow with the safeties with it, okay? I have an inside leverage on the on this apex slot, all right? I'm almost head up, a little bit inside leverage on this right here, all right? So we're going to go 50 look, quarterback sees that I have a good window for grass here, okay? I like the space to the field on this, okay? Quarterback now sees it. He's head up. I'm good either way. That's a head up leverage. I can break off, run the flat. I can run the hitch. He's good on anything that he does with this right here. Okay. So he sits, he breaks the slant, bangs it in, big tight end, tight body. Okay. Gives us a good first down. Okay. And so kind of finishing up on what we do in the Carolina shoot. People think that, you know, run a shoot is, and to a degree, the June Jones, the Mouse Davises, they're going to sit here and throw the football. Okay. What we end up doing every year. Okay. And we've thrown the ball, 36 to 3,800 one season. And then we actually ran the ball for about 30. The most that we ran in a single season was 35. And so we're going to be a little bit more balanced in what we do with the run and shoot. And that's just because of the of who I've coached with and kind of the philosophy that we take as we go. And we kind of break down every season with it. The first thing that we do when we look at our philosophy is understand that we have to utilize the personnel that we have. Okay. Even in the run and shoot. Okay. I love the run and shoot. Me as a growing up as a quarterback, I would want to throw the ball 60, 70, 80 times a game if I could. Okay. However, I grew up in a household whose head football coach, and my head coach was my dad, who is an offensive lineman. My brother played, he was a 3-year starter at East Carolina on the offensive line. And so we were instilled at an early age that you have to run the football. Okay. And so part of this kind of creating this Carolina shoot philosophy is the first thing that we do every year is utilize the personnel that we have. All right. Once we know what our personnel is, we have to identify the playmakers and then get them the football. Okay. So figure out what our personnel is. Okay. And then once we figure out the personnel that we have, we've got to now get the playmakers the football. The second thing that we believe in is now we got to spread the defense. Okay. And this is really big for us. We have to gain the numbers advantage in the run game specifically, but we're going to stretch the defense both vertically and horizontally. Okay. And we want to vertically stretch the defense. All right. Third thing is we're going to keep the defense accountable. How do we do that? Okay. How are you going to keep a defense accountable? Number one, you can play at a tempo, all right, that allows the defense to play a very vanilla type scheme. Okay. 2-minute pace the entire game. Force the defense to give something up. Okay. And that's kind of what our philosophy is with this. Okay. Even though we're running shoot and we have the potential to throw the football every single play. Okay. We're going to force the defense to give something up. If you're going to sit, you're going to drop 8. Okay. As much as I love to throw the football, we're going to run the football. Okay. And so we're going to force you to give something up. All right. Are you going to pack the box and force us to throw it? Or now you're going to drop 8 and force us to run it. Okay. We're going to force you to give something up. Next thing is we're going to force the defense to play sound concepts. Okay. How do we force the defense to play sound concepts and don't give us any kind of exotic blitzes or anything like that? In my opinion, you play at a pace that allows that to happen. And so our 2-minute tempo forces the defense to do that. Next thing is we have to be able to run the football to win. Okay. Now I'm not sitting here saying that we have to run it, you know, 50, 60, 70 times a game. We have to be able to run to win. We have to be able to establish the line of scrimmage and control the line of scrimmage. Okay. And then lastly, we have to execute. And so once we end up doing all these things philosophically, that's kind of what breaks down the Carolina shoot versus the run and shoot. In my opinion is, you know, we believe that we still have to run the football to win. Okay. Utilize the personnel that we have, gain the numbers advantage, attack it vertically and horizontally, keep the defense accountable, run the football to win. And then ultimately the game is about execution. Okay. If we can out execute you, we feel that we can be productive in what we do. Okay. And so hopefully this has kind of helped you out with what we're doing in the Carolina shoot. And any questions or anything that you have, please feel free to email me, call me, shoot me up a message on Twitter. Again, thank you for your time. Hopefully you got something out of this, and God bless you and hope you guys have a great 2021 year.